So, dear students, are you motivated by the life of Babar Ali? Now, here is Babar Ali talking to us himself. Let us listen to him. And as he talks to us, let us be motivated to be successful like him in our lives. So, today's lesson will be proceeded by watching this video.
I am coming from Murshidabad in the state of West Bengal. Murshidabad, one is the poorest district across the country. The village where I still live is a remote one, far from the modernization. When I was a student of class 5 only and a boy of 9 years old, I myself used to visit 10 kilometers far away school. 8 kilometers by bus and 2 kilometers by walk. And after returning from my school, in the afternoon, I saw some children, they are working in the fields, they are grazing the cattle. And I collected these children and started a school in my family backyard with 8 children. And my sister was my first student. Though, at first, I took it as my game. Gradually, it became my passion, my nice dream, my heart and life. Number of students started increased and my school became a dreamland for the helpless children. It was named Anondo Shikha Niketan, the home of joyful learning. I think my school is a place where joyful learning is possible at every step. Right now, my family backyard school has 300 regular students. And right now the school has recognized by the West Bengal state government. But when I founded the Anondo Shikha Niketan, the village elders were very skeptic to educate their children. Hence, they did not understand the importance of education. When we went door to door to pursue the parents to send their children, the first question I was asked, how education can important who cannot afford 2 square meals in a day? The girls will educated and do not find the husbands, others quit. But I left all the criticisms and went ahead with my plans. Right now in my school, 60% are girls and 40% are boys. And not only that, my district is a very big district, lots of good people, parliamentarian, even our honorable president is from our district. And our district is near Bangladesh border. So lots of problem in our district. Though right now my students are going for higher studies. But in India, if you go any places, you can find the migrant labor who are coming from Murshidabad district. But the children like this migrant labor, they are going for the higher studies. Even almost 100% are passing the board examination. And I need to say that 6 of my girls students, they are in the college level and they are also teaching at my school now. And they are all girls. And I am also getting support from the local community, but not much. I have the managing committee, and the managing committee people, they are also teaching at my school. Right now, I need to mention about this lady. She is Tulu Hajra. She is a fishermonger. In the morning, she sells fish in the village market. And in the afternoon, she bringing the children. She is uneducated and widow. Though she is helping me since eight years without any honorarium, and not only that, one of her granddaughters, she worked with her in Jaipur, Rajasthan, but after her 4th standard, she came back from Jaipur because there was the unhealthy position to work. And again, she attended my school and completed her education, and BBC also discovered her. Right now, she is also in college, and she is also teaching at my school. She is Jumki Hajra. and I hope I want to extend my school as a college level. Beside that, I want to give the technical and vocational education. Now I am convinced that nothing can stand against firm determination, firm conviction, and firm will. The only things you should have into your heart are courage, purity, honesty, and above all, love. Actually, I heard the call of love in the core of my heart and proceed and ultimately succeed. And we must leave a mark on the soil of this earth because we born in this earth. So, and right now, I am also doing my Master of Arts in English Literature, and this is my final year, and I want to be a student forever. And I have also started another school in 3 kilometers far away, where the school building is already completed. And after 12 years of my journey, now I am going to get the school building. And around 500 children will get the free education from the coming session, from January. And we are going to inaugurate the school in this November. However, education for all is my dream, and I am working to educate few hundreds of children. But the peoples like you, if you can come forward to actualize the dream where this education is still needed, I think we can make a better society. Thank you. And these two lines should be embossed on the tablet of our mind. Mileage to go before I sleep, and mileage to go before I sleep. Namaskar. Namaskar.
So, dear students, Babar Ali is the greatest example for our age. See what he says: nothing can come in between us if we have strong determination. He says that he had a call within his heart and he tried to fulfill it, try to reach it to the end. And you know, he started his career by teaching his own sister at home in the school. Imagine the small step that he had taken. Now it has grown into a mighty tree. It has become a big success story. So that's what we can learn from Babar Ali. Let's continue the lesson. The name of the school started by Babar Ali is Anand Shiksha Niketan. Babar Ali actually started his school at the mere age of 9. In fact, his school Anand Shiksha Niketan grew out of a game. We used to play school with me as teacher. My friends had never seen the inside of a school, so they enjoyed playing students. They ended up learning arithmetic and enjoying it, said Babar Ali while trying to explain how he initially started teaching. In 2002, the game got institutionalized with a strength of 8. Okay, see the way he has started his career. He was only 9 years old. You can imagine, playful age, childhood age. So whatever the children dream about in their future, they say that they will perform it in their childhood. Okay, if they become a driver, they will drive, take some toy cars and drive, etc. And this boy, Babar Ali, took the school life as a game. His school, Anand Shiksha Niketan, grew out of a game. We used to play school with me as teacher. My friends had never seen the inside of a school, so they started to play school game. Okay, like one is teacher and others are students. Actually, the students didn't know. The students who were there, they have not seen what is the inside of a school. Means they are poor children, they had not gone to school. Only Babar had gone to formal schooling. But these children did not go. But even then, they started to play that game. So they enjoyed playing students. They ended up learning arithmetic and enjoyed it. Okay, finally, what happened? By playing that game itself, they learned arithmetic. So Babar Ali says the start of his career. In 2002, the game got institutionalized with the strength of 8. That game became a reality in 2002. So when he started his own institute, it became a reality. Let's continue. So gradually word spread and the numbers grew. Help began to come from other quarters. Babar's own teachers, monks at the local Ramakrishna mission, sympathetic IAS officers, even local cops. When Babar first thought of a midday meal scheme, the rice came from his father's fields, but now with the aid of his friends in the administration, it comes from government stock. So gradually word spread and the numbers grew. Now this message that Babar Ali has started the school, that grew from mouth to mouth. Okay, janara nadve idu suddi haradito. And as the message spread about the school, number also grew. Many students started to come to his school. Now he needs aid, right? He needs some help. He cannot run school by himself without any money. And children are not paying to him. He is giving them free education. He needs money. So who is helping him now? Help began to come from other quarters. So when we start a good work, surely there will be many people who are coming forward to help us. Baba's own teachers in the school where he was going, they helped him. Monks at the local Ramakrishna mission. So there was a Ramakrishna mission and there were monks, priests, sannyasigalu, avaranu help madidaru. Sympathetic IAS officers, some IAS officers helped him, and even local cops, even the local police people, police personnel, and local people also, those who are able, they helped him. When Babar first thought up a midday meal scheme, the rice came from his father's fields. Our first busy uta yojana madvaga, avarige anna ellinda bantu, that came from his father's field. Avara tandeya gaddeyinda bantu first ge. But now, with the aid of friends in the administration, it comes from government stock. Aid andre help. Iga idu anna ellinda bartade, government inda sarkaradinda bartade. First avarige tande provide madthiru. ಆದರೆ ಈಗ ಇದು ಅನ್ನ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟಿಂದ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಸಾರಿ, ಅಕ್ಕಿ, ನಾಟ್ ಅನ್ನ, ಅಕ್ಕಿ. ಟುಡೇ 9 years ಡೌನ್ ದ ಲೈನ್, ದ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ 60 ರೆಗ್ಯುಲರ್ ಅಟೆಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಓವರ್ 220 ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ರೋಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 800 ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ವಿತ್ 10 ವಾಲಂಟಿಯರ್ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಗ್ರೇಡ್ಸ್ 1 through 8. So today, 9 years down the line, now 9 years passed with the school after starting the school. So the school has 60 regular attendance. You see, within 9 years, he got 60 regular attendees. Okay, they were coming regularly, 60 students, dinalu bartidru, and over 220 students on roll call. Okay, now 220 were there as per the attendance book. There were 220 students and 800 students in total. Okay, with 10 volunteer teachers teaching grades 1 to 8. So there were 10 volunteer teachers were there who were coming to teach maybe for free. That was their free service to the school. His little afternoon venture is now registered and recognized by the West Bengal state government, which means students graduating from Baba's school are eligible to be transferred to other local high schools. So now his little afternoon venture, our madhyana avandu start madida adondu sanna yojane, is now registered and recognized by the West Bengal state government. So today West Bengal state government has recognized that venture. ಅದೊಂದು ಯೋಜನೆಯನ್ನು ಇವತ್ತು ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ರೆಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. which means students graduating from Babar school are eligible andre yogyaragidare to be transferred to other local high schools ondu vele avaru Babar alina school alli kalitre avarge bere school ge transfer madabodu avara education primary education mugida nantara bere high school ge kalisabodu aa ondu eligibility yogyateyannu sarkara avara school ge labisitu. When the children of the village and the localities nearby are done with their chores and jobs at daytime, they run to attend Babar's afternoon school. They arrive in time for Tulu Mashi's opening bell. So how the children are responding to the school timings and bell, you see. When the children of the village and the localities nearby are done with their chores and jobs at daytime, so they have in their houses, children have their work, they do it. Chores means daily work, what they have to do, they finish it. Then they run to attend Babar's afternoon class. So afternoon they come to the class, there will be a bell rung by Tulu Mashis. Tulu Mashis rings the bell and Tulu Mashi rings the bell and the children are on time to the class. So let's meet some pure, good and kind souls. Clad in widow's whites, stick in hand, Tulurani Hazra is an illiterate fisher moga by morning and a crusading educationalist by afternoon. On fish selling rounds of nearby villages, her job is to confront erring parents who have stopped sending their children to school and to find new students. She has recruited 80 till now. So in the video you have seen, Babar Ali appreciates a widow woman who helps him for years. So meets, these are the people, these are the pure, good and kind souls who help him in his daily needs. Clad in widow's whites, clad means she is wearing. What is she wearing? Widow's white. You know, widows wear usually white clothes. And stick in hand, she has a stick in her hand. And Tulu Rani Hazra, her name is Tulu Rani Hazra. He's an illiterate fisher moga by morning. She sells fish in the morning and a crusading educationalist. What do you mean by crusading? Crusading means pertaining to a long and determining effort. Andre avarge tumba determination ide. Determination and effort inda avaru alli help madlige bartare afternoon. Okay. On fish selling rounds of nearby villages, her job is to confront erring parents. Avaru belige anta martare meenu maratake hogtare aga what is her job at that time? Meenu maratake hoguvaga avaru enta martare? She is correcting the confronting the erring parents. Erring andre tappu maduvavaru kelavondu parents tappu martare. Yava tappu? Who have stopped sending their children to school and to find new students. Okay, kelavondu parents galu students anna school ge kalisudannu ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಂಥ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಥ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸನ್ನು ಕರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದು ಮತ್ತು ಆ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ಪುನಃ ಶಾಲೆಗೆ ಹೋಗುವಂತೆ ಮಾಡೋದು ಈ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಈ ತುಲು ರಾಣಿ ಹಜ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮತ್ತೆ ಎಂತ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ? ಮತ್ತೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕೆಲಸ ಅವರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಶಿ ಫೈಂಡ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸ್ಕೂಲಿಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದ ನ್ಯೂ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸನ್ನು ಅವರು ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿತಾರೆ, ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವರನ್ನು ಸ್ಕೂಲಿಗೆ ಕರೆತರ್ತಾರೆ. ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಕ್ರೂಟೆಡ್ 80 ಟಿಲ್ ನೌ. ಓಕೆ, ಎಷ್ಟರವರೆಗೆ ಅವರು ಎಷ್ಟು ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸನ್ನು ರಿಕ್ರೂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಸ್ಕೂಲಿಗೆ ಕರೆ ತಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ? ನಿಯರ್ಲಿ 80 ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ಟು ದ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್. ಶಿ ಆರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಅರ್ ಎಫರ್ಟ್ ಎಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಏಜ್. ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಸೋ ಹಾರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಮೋಟ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್. ದ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಟಾಫ್ ಆಫ್ 9 ಈಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೈಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ವಾಲಂಟಿಯರ್ಸ್. ದೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆರ್ ಆವರೇಜ್ ಟೀನೇಜರ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಬಾಬರ್ ಇನ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್. The most educated Debrita goes to college in Berhampur. Okay, now who are the teachers in this school? The teaching staff of 9. So what is the total number of teaching staff there? 9. Okay, alli 9 9 mandi teachers galu iddare, made up of high school student volunteers. Now who are these teaching teachers? These are not B.Ed or D.Ed trainees or such teachers. These are high school students or voluntarily coming forward to teach in his school. They also are average teenagers, so their age also is a teenage, who are helping out Babar to make a difference. So when you help one another, you can surely make a difference. The most educated Debarita goes to college in Berhampur. So among these teachers, who is the most educated one? Debarita. She goes to a college in a close by village. Babar Ali gives lessons just the way he has heard from his teachers. There is no building or establishment for his school. He teaches his students under the open sky. Some children sit in the mud, others on rickety branches under a rough homemade shelter. The family chickens scratch around nearby. In every corner of the yard, groups of children can be seen studying hard. So, Babar Ali gives lessons just the way he has heard from his teachers. So, the way he has heard, ಹೇಗೆ ಅವರ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಅವರಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸಿದಾರ ಹಾಗೆಯೇ ಬಾಬರ್ ಅಲಿ ತಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಕಲಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ವಾಸ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಎಟ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್. ಈ ಟೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಓಪನ್ ಸ್ಕೈ. ಸಮ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್ ಸಿಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಡ್, ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ರಿಕೆಟಿ ಬ್ರಾಂಚಸ್. ಸೊ ರಿಕೆಟಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ poorly made. Okay, there are some poorly made or likely to collapse. Benches are there, not branches, benches are there, which are in poor condition. Okay, on that they sit under a rough homemade shelter. So the shelter is alli ashray yegide andre ond rough marada maniya tara ide. Okay, the top part of the that place. The family chickens scratch around nearby. Andre maneyalli iruva koligalu, they come there and scratch around. So ella kade avaru avara adara aarakagi hudukaadtave. So the hens will be around. In every corner of the yard, groups of children can be studying hard. So if you see everywhere, at every corner of that place, there will be groups of children sitting and studying. They are studying very well. Hold them means in the afternoons, they study very well, they study hard. It's much easier to enroll kids who are not old enough. So class 1 and 2 have over 200 students. Class 8 has just 20 students. They study 10 subjects and are mostly likely taught by Babar and Debarita Bhattacharya. Debarita is another volunteer who has been helping out for a long time now. So it's much easier to enroll kids who are not old enough. Okay. In present day school system, we have rules. When we have to admit children, they should be of certain age. You can't just admit. But in Babar Ali school, there are no particular rules. You can admit students at any time. So class 1 and 2 have over 200 students. So there is no rule to admit the children in the school. They just bring in the children. So total there are 200 students. Class 8 has just 20 students. They study 10 subjects and more likely taught by Babar and Debarita Bhattacharya. So 5 school students, these two manage, Debarita and Babar. Debarita is another volunteer who has been helping out for a long time. That's what we have seen. The Debarita is a college graduate. So she also helps Babar from a long time. Let's look into the meanings of some new words that we have learnt in this part. Clad means wear. Crusading means pertaining to a long and determined effort. Erring is making mistake. And rickety means poorly made or likely to collapse. For your better understanding, let's read the text once again. Anand Shiksha Niketan. From there we had started. Babar Ali actually started his school at the mere age of 9
In fact, his school, Anand Shikshaniketan, grew out of a game. We used to play school with me as teacher. My friends had never seen the inside of a school, so they enjoyed playing students. They ended up learning arithmetic and enjoying it, said Babar Ali while trying to explain how he initially started teaching. In 2002, the game got institutionalized with the strength of 8. So gradually word spread and the numbers grew. Help began to come from other quarters. Babar's own teachers, monks at the local Ramakrishna Mission, sympathetic IAS officers, even local cops. When Babar first thought up a midday meal scheme, the rice came from his father's fields, but now with the aid of friends in the administration, it comes from government stock. Today, 9 years down the line, the school has 60 regular attendants and over 220 students on roll call and 800 students in total, with 10 volunteer teachers teaching grades 1 through 8. His little afternoon venture is now registered and recognized by the West Bengal state government, which means students graduating from Babar's school are eligible to be transferred to the other local schools. When the children of the village and the localities nearby are done with their chores and jobs at daytime, they run to attend Babar's afternoon school. They arrive in time for Tulu Mashi's opening bell. Meet some pure good kind souls, clad in whites, widow's whites, stick in hand. Tulurani Hazra is an illiterate fishermonger by morning and a crusading educationalist by afternoon. On fish selling rounds of nearby villages, her job is to confront erring parents who have stopped sending their children to school and to find new students. She has recruited 80 till now. The teaching staff of 9 is made up of high school student volunteers. They also are average teenagers who are helping out Babar in making a difference. The most educated Brita goes to college in Berhampur. Babar Ali gives lessons just the way he has heard them from his teachers. There is no building or establishment for his school. He teaches his students under the open sky. Some children sit in the mud, others on rickety benches under a rough homemade shelter. The family chickens scratch around nearby. In every corner of the yard, groups of children can be seen studying hard. It's much easier to enroll kids who are not old enough. So class 1 and 2 have over 200 students. Class 8 has just 20 students. They study 10 subjects and are mostly taught by Babar and Debarita Bhattacharya. Debarita is another volunteer who has been helping out for a long time now. So that's all for today. Let's proceed in the next class.